Now let's have a look at the capacity of a battery. We use batteries to store electric energy. Batteries normally have two main attributes. One of them is a voltage, and the other one is capacity of a battery. Batteries provide electric voltage to circuits where they are installed, so they serve as voltage sources. As such, voltage is always clearly specified when we talk about batteries. Now, the capacity is a tricky one because capacity can sometimes mean electric charge that is stored in battery, and sometimes can mean electric energy that is stored in battery. It is very important to distinguish between the two because we are really talking about two different electrical quantities. One of the good ways to distinguish between the two is to look at the unit. So when we talk about electric charge that is stored in the battery, we normally express electric charge in amp hours. Now, in electrical engineering, we sometimes use coulombs, but amp hours is actually a better unit because it tells us really how much of a current battery can provide for how long. In other words, if we have certain capacity expressed in amp hours, we can drain that battery for 1 hour with as many amps as the capacity of it is. Capacity of a battery expressed as a charge that is stored in the battery is actually industry norm, and that is normally specified when we look at the label of a battery. However, capacity of a battery expressed as the amount of energy stored in the battery is more important. We are actually more interested in how much energy can be stored in a battery. Now, that is usually not a problem. In order to obtain the amount of electric energy stored in the battery, we need to multiply the amount of electric charge stored in the battery with battery's voltage. So, as I mentioned, voltage is always clearly specified, so we know how much that is. And also charge, as a capacity of a battery, is also the norm of being specified. So, we can obtain the amount of energy simply by multiplying CA and V. So let's perform a little bit of calculations with capacity of a battery. I'm going to use a AAA battery, AA battery, and a standard car battery. So let's first have a quick look as to how AA and AAA batteries are labeled.
I have two batteries here. The larger one is AA battery, and the smaller one is AAA battery. The AAA battery is 1.2 volts, 1000 milliamp hours battery. And then AA battery is 1.2 volts, 2600 milliamp hours. Now this is a mobile phone battery. It has been used in my old cell phone. As you can see, the charge capacity is given here. It is 2100 milliamp hours. And then on the other side, we have energy capacity, which is 7.98 watt hours, and the voltage is 3.8 volts. Note that this is lithium ion battery. It is not nickel metal hydride. Here is yet another battery. This one is used in a laptop. As you can see here, we also have lithium ion battery. It is 15 volt battery, and we're given both the charge capacity, 5,900 milliamp hours, and also energy capacity, 88 watt hours.
So the AAA battery that I have in this example is rechargeable nickel metal hydride battery, and its voltage is labeled as 1.2 volts. Also, when fully charged, this battery can contain 1,000 milliamp hours of charge. That is equivalent to 1 amp hour. So knowing the voltage and the amount of charge stored in this battery, we can calculate the amount of energy that is stored in this little AAA battery. So CW is CA times V, which is 1 amp hour of charge, times 1.2 volts, which equals 1.2 watt hours. That is not some tremendous amount of energy, but at least we have calculated how much of energy we have in one AAA battery. Similarly, AA batteries have the same voltage, but their capacity is larger. So there we have 2.6 amp hours. So when we calculate the amount of energy stored in a AA battery, we can see that we obtain roughly three times more, or 3.12 watt hours of energy. So let's have a quick look as to how car batteries are being labeled. So this is my Toyota, and I want to check the label on my battery. I'm interested to see what is the capacity of this battery and to see what does the manufacturer put on the plate for a battery. Okay, so let's see what does it say on this label. Well, the first thing we can see is this is a 12 volts battery. And then the other important thing that we want to read here is the capacity of this battery is 60 amp hours. The cold cranking amps value, or CCA, is obviously 356 amps, which is really not something that we are interested to talk about right now. Okay, so you have seen that this car battery has 12 volts, which is quite a standard voltage for car installations. And the capacity, again, as the amount of charge stored in this car's battery, is 60 amp hours. So we can calculate the amount of energy stored in this battery as 60 amp hours times 12 volts, which is 720 watt hours. Just note that the common AA and AAA batteries that we see in ordinary life are usually non-chargeable batteries, and they have voltage 1.5 volts. 1.5 volts is obviously different than the voltage of these rechargeable batteries, and that is the consequence of a different chemistry of those non-chargeable batteries. Now let's have a look at one exercise question. So the question is, how many AAA size batteries will be needed to replace a standard car battery? So we can remind ourselves what we read off of the labels of a car battery and the AAA battery. So car battery had capacity expressed as 60 amp hours, whereas AAA battery has its capacity expressed as 1000 milliamp hours, which is same as 1 amp hour. Obviously, capacity for car battery is 60 times larger than capacity of a AAA battery. Does that mean that we need 60 AAA batteries in order to replace a one car battery? Well, the answer is no. We cannot compare charge capacities if we talk about batteries that have different voltages. So because the voltages are different, we need to take into account voltages, and we need to calculate the energy that is stored in each one of those batteries, so then we can perform a proper comparison. So knowing that car battery's voltage is 12 volts, we can calculate energy stored in car battery as 720 watt hours. AAA battery has 1.2 volts, so that corresponds to 1.2 watt hours of energy stored in AAA battery. Dividing 720 watt hours with 1.2 watt hours, we obtain 600. That means we need 600 AAA batteries in order to replace one car battery. Thank you for watching this video about capacity of a battery. I hope you learned something. I'll see you in the next video.